Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani, and today we're talking about a unit of Botox. What exactly is a unit of Botox? In quick review, one of our videos from the last few months was about the unit of Botox, and the number one question that everyone asks when they call the clinic, how much is your unit of Botox? And what we discussed was so much more goes into that than, first of all, people don't know what a unit is. They don't know when they leave, did they get 20 units or 80 or one? It's difficult to measure. The quality of the unit, where it came from, we covered all those things, but people then ask me, Dr. Johnny, what does it mean? What is a unit of Botox? Because if you go and you get aspirin or Tylenol, it's usually milligrams. Why is Botox in units and what the heck is that? So one unit of Botox is the LD50 of one Swiss mouse, a Webster mouse, and they weigh about 20 grams or 0.02 kilograms, so it's tiny. The LD50 is a lethal dose at 50%. That means if you give this mouse one unit, within a few days, the mouse will pass on from that amount in 50% of cases. So the unit is based on a lethal dose in half of the mice that they treat with one unit. That's where the unit comes from. What they found when you study the vials, if you think that's one unit, that's a small amount, the vials have variability beyond that. And also then, if you think about what we're putting in a human, when we talk about 100 units being the average, and there's a video on that, if you think about 100 units and you extrapolate that, which is inexact science, that would take you to a 2 kilograms lethal dose for 2 kilograms. So if you do the math, it's a small dose that we're putting in humans, and that's where a unit comes from. The most important thing, of course, applying to the real world, is going to somewhere, of course, where they do this on a regular basis. You're getting fresh units. And someone who's doing this a lot, because of course the units are different amongst Botox, Dysport, and Xeomin, which is what we have in this country. And so knowing the conversion and the little different nuances, and real quick between those, are really the differences of binding proteins. It's the same Botox type of molecule that stops the release of acetylcholine and muscle contraction. But now you know what a unit is, a lot of people ask, and where it comes from and how we get to it. And most vials, Botox is 50 to 100 units, Dysport's 300 units, and Xeomin's 50 or 100 units is what we get them in. So thanks for joining me today. Let us know below what you think of all this. What's your Botox experience? We use Botox, we mean all of them. Let us know below. So join us on this channel for continued helpful tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.